Hi friends, welcome to our channel. Today we will discuss OOPS concept in Python. Here OOPS concept means object oriented principles. Generally, these OOPS paradigm, the programs are written by using classes and objects. The OOPS paradigm is designed by using an object. The object contains, the set of attributes and the functions. So some of the OOPS principles are, class, object, inheritance, polymorphism, encapsulation and abstraction. The OOPS principles are class, object, inheritance, polymorphism, encapsulation and abstraction. First we will define class. Class is simply a blueprint. That means class define a logical structure, simple terms, and this structure is followed by objects. Generally, class defines the real world scenario. Each class contains attributes and functions. For example, employee. Here the name of the class is employee. This employee class contains some attributes. ID of the employee, name of the employee, and salary of the employee. Suppose along with these attributes, class contains some functions or procedures or methods for accessing these values. For example, some methods, read of, count of, any some methods. Read the salary of employee, count the salary of employee, read the ID of employee, whatever it is. This is a class. Generally, class specifies a real world scenario. This is a real world scenario of an employee, which contains some attributes and some methods. This is a logical structure. This structure is followed by the objects. This is a class. Okay. Simple definition. Class is a blueprint or logical structure followed by a set of objects. Now move to object. So here I am not specifying any syntax. So we will discuss each and every one with the example later. Here now I will explain the concepts only. Okay. Now object. So everyone know object is simply an instance of a class. So class defines the logical structure that is followed by an object. So automatically object is a physical entity. Suppose in here previously I am stating that employee with some attributes ID, name, salary. Suppose if ID is equal to 1, salary is equal to 20,000, name is equal to some XYZ. That is, that employee exists. In the real world, if exists, that is an object. So object is a physical entity and it is an instance of a class. So for a class, we compulsory create an object. Whenever we are creating an object, then only we are allocating memory for the class. Simply class, there is no use. Without an object, the class has no use. Suppose I am defining a logical structure. Without accessing this logical structure, there is no use. Without an employee, there is no need of that particular class. So whenever I am creating an object, then only a memory is allocated for the class. So if the class contains attributes and methods, now then object also contains the attributes and methods and the object access the class simply by using the dot operator. By using object name dot class name, object name dot class name. Okay, we are creating class name is here not the class name, the variables in the class, the methods in the class. So simply those are called the class members. By using object name dot class members, we are accessing all the members present in the class. That is an object. Okay, now move to inheritance. Inheritance means one class or object, both are same. One class acquires properties of another class. One class acquires the properties of another class, or one object acquires the properties of another class. That is, I already defined one class. Suppose I am creating a new class. That new class has to acquire the properties from the already defined class. That is called inheritance. Inheritance. So the main advantage of inheritance is reusability of the code. Main advantage is reusability of the code. That is the main advantage of inheritance. In this inheritance, we have many types: single level inheritance, multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hybrid inheritance. We will discuss all those types of inheritance in the later session. So inheritance means one class acquires the properties from another class. Here the class that acquires properties from another class, the getting class is known as derived class. Another name is child class. So derived class or child class means the class which acquires the property, and the class which provide the property or from which class we are getting, that class is called parent class or base class. That class is called parent class or base class. This is inheritance. Now move to polymorphism. So everyone know poly means many. Poly means many. Morphism means forms. So that means meaning is many forms. That is, one method or one variable behaves in different ways in different context. The method defines behaves in different ways. For example, consider a method display. Suppose consider a method display with some argument. For example, display of some data. It displays the data. Suppose in another context, the method display of id comma salary with two parameters, it behaves in another fashion. That is, the name of the method is same. The name of the method is same, but in different context it behaves in different ways. For example, plus symbol. In normal numeric, the plus symbol acts as addition of two numbers. Suppose in strings, the plus symbol acts as the concatenation. So that is the polymorphism. In this polymorphism, we will discuss overloading and overriding. Overloading and overriding. Suppose if you are using a single class, we are implementing method overloading. If you are using more than one class, that is, inheritance concept is applied, then overriding comes into play. So that is a polymorphism. That means one method behaves different ways in different contexts. Next, encapsulation. Next one is encapsulation means wrapping up of or binding. Both the meanings are same. Wrapping up of data. Data means the attributes and the functions. Data and the functions. Functions means the code. Data and functions into a single unit. Wrapping up of, that is the binding or combining of data and the code that uses the data, that is called functions, into a single unit is called encapsulation. we already implementing. Suppose the attributes and the functions are written inside a class, that is all those are binded under the class name, that is encapsulation. The main advantage of encapsulation is, remember, this is the main advantages: restricted access. So we directly not access each and every member of the class. The encapsulation provides a restricted access to the members of a class. Here, restricted access, how we are providing restriction? By using access specifiers. By using access specifiers, restriction on the members of the class is provided. Suppose the access specifiers are public, that is any code outside the class also can access. Private, only the members inside the class, that is the functions or methods inside the class can only access. Protected, only the members inside the class along with the child classes also. Child classes means the inherited concept, inherited classes. In public, any class can access members of any class. Private, only the members present within the class can only access the private variables. Protected means along within the class, along with the child classes can also use the variables or methods. So here these are applied to either variables or methods. That means we are providing restrictions on the access. That is called encapsulation. That is called encapsulation. And the finally, abstraction. Abstraction means hiding the internal details of a function and exposing what the function do. So hiding internal details of the function and shows only the functionality. Internal details are hidden and the functionality is stored. In simple terms, abstraction specifies what the function does, but does not specify how it does. Okay, the implementation details are not shown to the user. It specifies this function is used for this function. Suppose we have many operating systems or many functions or many apps. It shows only the functionality of the particular application. But how the application is designed, the details are not to the user. The details only for developers. So that is an abstraction. These are the object-oriented principles: class, object, inheritance, polymorphism, encapsulation, abstraction. So in the later sessions, we will discuss each and every principle along with creation and example. Thank you.